Afternoon all, Mark here, Intelligent Triathlon Training, and Sam. So we are back at the Performance Centre in Loughborough University for his bike testing. So similar format to run testing earlier, but let's go in and have a look and then we'll explain a little bit more about what we're going to be doing. So here we are back in the lab. So today we're down the other end. We're on the bike down there. Setup we've got this week for this test is using his own bike, and super important that he is on the time trial position. So it's racing in time trial position. We want to test every, certainly sub-max side of things in time trial position. Another one of my pet hates, you'll get used to this, is that I see a lot of people testing on erg bikes and things like that in sat up, bolt upright, trying to use the information from that to then set training prescription. What we can see quite clearly when we look at testing, and anybody who's probably done this at home will realise that when you're in the time trial position, heart rate gets elevated for the same power because you're of the sort of impingement effectively through folding over and getting into a decent aero position. So we want to know what the cost of riding is at in the position that he's going to spend the majority of his time riding in. So it's super important to be doing these tests on your own bike as much as possible, or at least in the position that you're going to be racing in as much as you can. So we're going to use 6 minute stages. We're starting 160 watts, going up 20 watts every stage. Keep going until we're confident he is over second threshold. One of the differences we're going to do in this test compared to the run test is that we're going to take, after first threshold, we're going to take a blood lactate sample every 3 minutes. So midway through the stage and then at the end of the stage. So this is just another way of looking to see when we go over second threshold, we should be seeing an escalation of between 3 minutes and 6 minutes. Below second threshold, we shouldn't see much change from 3 minutes to 6 minutes. So it's just another way of reinforcing we're doing that. The reason we don't do it on the treadmill is because we take the sample from the ear, and it's not practical to be able to take that mid-run. So as you saw, if you watched the run part of it, then we stop the treadmill, take the sample, get cracking again. So we're going to do that through to, we're obviously collecting expired air again, we're getting RPEs, we get heart rate, et cetera, et cetera. We use Zwift as the means to be able to set the protocol and to control it, just because of the simplicity of it and because, well, it's a little bit more engaging than just sitting at a blank screen, isn't it? So once we've done that, we'll have a bit of a recovery period, about 20 minutes or so, and then he'll go into his max test, and I'll go through the max test when we get there. So let's go have a look, see how he's getting on. So we're now about into probably the latter stages of the testing. We've started taking samples every 3 minutes within the 6 minute stage, and looking to see what happens with the progression in blood lactate levels from that 3 minutes to 6 minutes. What we saw in the early stages was actually it would go down, so at 3 minutes, we'd see a slightly higher value, and then lactate levels would come down by the time we got to 6 minutes. What we're seeing as we get closer to second threshold is that it goes up, and initially it's pretty consistent, so we might get, say for instance, two and then two again. As we get pretty close to second threshold, we're gonna see 2, 2.5, 3 or 3.5, whatever. And that sort of, again, shows that from an energetics and a fatigue perspective, he's starting to accumulate hydrogen ions. It's not, the lactic acid is not the blood lactate. Let's not get into that debate. It's merely a marker of an increase in acidosis that we can use to predict fatigue. So we can also see in the background there, I think you can see the gas data on the analyzer over there, that if you watch the earlier one, we're talking about the red and the blue lines, the carbon dioxide and the oxygen lines, then that carbon dioxide line is starting to creep up. We're pretty close to one on the RER scale, which you probably can't quite see from here, is the number on the bottom right-hand corner, which means we've probably got one, maybe two more stages left, probably one. So that's it, end of the submax test. 20 minutes, 25 minutes, just spinning along, bit of recovery now, and then we'll go into the fast ramp max test. So we're into the max test now. We've got his all masked up, ready to go, starting from fairly low power, around 160 watts for him. It's going to go up 5 watts every 15 seconds, and it's just going to keep going until he can't keep up with it anymore. So he needs to keep his cadence pretty constant. It can change throughout, but he can't keep going up and down, because the trainers and things like that will get messed up and it won't provide the right resistance. So keeping cadence consistent, but a lot of people will, for instance, might start on the lower intensities when it's quite easy. Some people might be higher, some people might be lower, but actually as you get to the meat and bones of it, you go through threshold and you get towards max rated power, then sometimes people prefer either a slightly higher cadence or a slightly lower cadence at that point there. So as long as that's subtly changed, then it's fine. It's when you suddenly go big changes, then the device gets confused, and because it's what it's trying to do in erg mode, it's trying to make you average the power output that you've set for that stage. If cadence drops, clearly power's dropping as well. So it then loads up more, which means cadence drops a bit more and you end up in a vicious cycle of failing too early. So you've got to be really on it with cadence, not with the power output. So we won't do anything during the course of the test. So basically it's a bit of a spectator sport for us now until he's sort of laying in a puddle somewhere in the back of the bike, hopefully. Starting to get interesting now. We are approaching 400 watts. So expecting him, according to my bet, he'll get into the 400 watts somewhere along the line. Probably a little bit more.
Keep driving, Sam. Keep it going.
I have to hedge my bets now. Anything over 440 would be well ahead of schedule. You can see in the screen over on the back there on the gas data. Let's see if I can figure out how to do this. See on that, we've got blue and red lines starting to converge. It's a fast ramp, so what you're seeing on the screen is, whilst it might be breath by breath and it's sort of pretty much instantly what he's doing, what it's actually doing is showing you what the physiology was a minute ago, because it takes that long to process through the body, which is why judging anything other than max off a fast ramp max test is fairly pointless.
Going, come on now. Go 4-4-5, come on, keep driving, let's go. Go on, Sam, give everything a breath. Come on, let's go. Keep going, come on, let's go. Really nicely done here. As he's smashing it.
Final lactate should be taken here. See if you can see how high it goes. So looking at that, we can see obviously red lines continue escalating. We've got a little bit of a plateau there on the blue line, which to be expected, so we generally expect when somebody's achieved true VO2 max, then there will be a slight plateau towards the end. And I think we've pretty much achieved that. So gold standard testing today by the looks of things, in terms of certainly the execution of them. So like everybody, all we want to do is make the numbers higher. All testing finished. Now we just got to wait and let the guys do their job and process all the information. And we can start to look through that in a bit more detail. We'll match it up with the training he's been doing, the objectives we've got for the season, and start to create the plan, the master plan. When we get that through, put another video together, show you what it looks like, for better or for worse. Till next time.